This is a rare opportunity. We don't get to do this that much because I don't know why, but it's like the good old days of like hearing a song that you love and it's kind of undiscovered, and so is the artist behind the song. And that's what's happening right now, this Monday, October 23rd, 2017. Meet Malia. Good morning.
Welcome.
Good morning.
I just with the name, you have roots in Hawaii.
Yes.
I'm guessing, right?
Yes. Lived there when I was very young. My parents worked in the hotel industry, so I actually lived in a hotel when I was very young.
Well, you're going to probably live in hotels a lot because this is I think this song is going to blow up. It's really a great song. So this is truly your first time being in a radio station, right?
Yes, the very first one.
An interview.
Mm-hmm. So cool.
And you went to USC for a little while?
Yes, I was a popular music major at USC, graduated last year. It was an incredible time.
Good
and
for you.
Through USC, I met the incredible guys that signed me and the two amazing songwriters who've worked with Ariana Grande, Charlie Puth, Selena Gomez, Maroon 5. I mean, their credentials are insane.
You just walked into all of that? That's incredible.
Yes. I'm very, very proud to be working with them.
So when you were at USC, obviously you were studying what you love, mm-hmm. but were you also a little bit antsy that you wanted to go do it?
Oh, for sure. It was always this balance of like trying to be in school, and I've always loved school. And growing up, I was a nerd and got straight A's, which is why I was able to go to USC, because got a bunch of academic scholarships, singing scholarships. And so it was always this interesting balance of trying to be in school, half being in school and half
right.
being in the real world and trying to do gigs so I could pay my way through college
right.
pretty much.
Well, this is one of those moments. You're going to hear this song that you've not heard before, and you're going to like it. And I think you're going to hear it often, and I think you're going to hear about Malia a lot. Tell us about Champagne Clouds, the song I'm about to play.
So Champagne Clouds, actually inspired by a lot of my time at USC, was written about the fact that I don't leave parties. So it was about all of my friends being like, okay, Malia, it's time to go. And I'd go, okay, bye. And I'll see you guys later.
And you
my
stay.
Kind of girl.
Yeah. And so I would stay. I was just very, very much lived in the party world and love to have a good time, sing and dance. And just...
did your friends ever come get you, or did you spend the night?
Like, I generally would find my way home.
You
at
would get
some
there somehow.
Point. At some point, but okay. As to what that point was, you know, you never really know.
Take a listen to this. It is the world premiere. It's called Champagne Clouds. It's Malia, 102.7 Kiss FM. If you are going, that's a really good song. It is. It's called Champagne Clouds. It's Malia. This is all brand new. It's brand new music. She's new to our scene, sis.
That was her first time hearing it on the radio. Like, it's never been played anywhere.
Never anywhere.
I need to put myself in. What kind of shoes are you wearing?
I'm actually in Kylie and Kendall's. There's these awesome white boots.
I need to put myself in your boots. What is it like to hear it on the radio?
It's very surreal because this is something that I've been working towards actually my entire life. I've been performing since I was 5.
Gosh.
And I started, I mean, even before that, when I lived in Hawaii, I literally would dance hula and my parents would take me to client dinners.
Yeah.
And I would like sneak out of my high chair and go up with the hula dancers and just dance with them.
Aww.
Right.
When I was like 3. And it's never really stopped.
Did you have to do different jobs through school?
Oh,
when
yeah.
When you were going to USC, what were you doing?
I worked 2 different paid internships when I was a freshman, taking a full course load, as well as doing different performances for conventions, things with a band, national anthems, just basically anything that I could to help pay my way through school, pretty much.
Do you know what's so wonderful? First of all, these are moments why I love this job.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is, for me, this is the greatest thing about this gig, is when we get to meet someone like you, play a song which is that is about to be a massive worldwide hit song.
Thank you.
But do you understand? Like, that is, I mean, before I worked here, I was like, oh my gosh, that's Kiss FM. Like,
yeah.
That's Kiss FM Los Angeles.
Exactly.
I still get like that when I come in here.
Oh yeah.
You were just played on the playlist with everybody.
I'm literally still pinching myself.
But what's so wonderful to see, I don't know who the people are that came with you that are in the other room, but they're beaming with pride and grinning
from
ear to ear.
They're my family.
Is this your fam?
No, well, I mean, they're my music
musical
family.
Family.
Yes, my
but
musical
they're just
family.
Like hugging yeah. each other and high-fiving. And
it's crazy to think that our next song is Charlie Puth, Attention.
Oh, my
so
gosh.
It's like,
yeah.
you know what I mean? It's like you're sandwiched in between all these major artists.
Which was actually yeah. written by my man, Jay Cash.
Yeah.
So. And so, yeah, tell us that story. So, Attention, written by Jay Cash, Charlie's song, and also wrote that song.
Yes. So, I met Jay Cash a year ago through Ross Golan, also fellow USC alum. And it was very interesting because post-college, I kind of had to figure my own stuff out. I didn't quite have enough money to have an apartment, so I was pretty much living out of my car, couch surfing, and was actually, like, for all intents and purposes, homeless a year ago today.
A year ago today,
which is insane. When I found out that we were doing this today, I was like, whoa, what can happen in a year is actually incredible. And so Ross introduced me to Jay Cash, and we started creating music, and I was writing with all of my writing partners, and I actually wrote Champagne Clouds with my roommate, the guy who's now one of my roommates.
Who was your carmate at the time?
who was not my carmate at the time. Who is eventually I signed to Warner Chappell for publishing and signed a deal with Friends with Pens, which is Ross and Cash's label. And so I was finally able to have a real place to live that was not my car.
So you're listening to the story of Malia, artist that we just played. And I'm so, it's interesting in life when you trace. You worked hard, you did those jobs, you went to school, and then you'll look back and there will be these seminal moments in your career. Mm-hmm. This is one of them. Yeah. This is one of them. And John Ivy, called me over the weekend so excited about this song and discovering you. And it's just a wonderful thing. And I wish you the most tremendous success and good luck. And thank you for coming here to share just the beginning.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. And thank you to John Ivy for helping make all of this happen.
I'm going to go sit on his lap later and thank him. He loves it.
I would, but I don't know if that would go over well.
The only reason I say is because he's the one in our office that dresses like Santa Claus for the holidays. And so it's coming. The holidays are coming. He just flipped me the bird. All right. Malia, it's a pleasure. We are such big fans, and good luck. Continued
thank you,
success, okay?